Hello students, in this video I'll be discussing about Green's theorem in a plane. If m n dou m by dou y and dou n by dou x are continuous in a region R bounded by a simple closed curve C, then integral C m dx plus n dy is equal to double integral over R dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y dx dy. Now to understand this, let us verify if this is true. So verify Green's theorem in a plane for integral C 3x minus 8 y squared dx plus 4y minus 6xy dy, where C is bounded by x equal to 0, y equal to 0, x plus y equal to 1. So basically, C is a triangle, the boundary of the triangle formed by x equal to 0, y equal to 0, and x plus y equal to 1. So we have this is y equal to 0, this will be x equal to 0, and x plus y equal to 1. X equal to 0 implies y equal to 1, so we get 0 comma 1. Y equal to 0 implies x equal to 1, which gives us 1 comma 0. So we mark those points 1 0 and 0 1, joining them. So we have, we'll call this as C1, C2 and C3. So C is C1 plus C2 plus C3. So we need to evaluate the integral along each of these curves and then add them up to get the result. Now along C1, C1 is the x-axis. So equation is y equal to 0, which implies dy is 0. Now C1 is x equal to 0 to 1. Therefore, integral C1 m dx plus n dy, this is equal to integral 0 to 1 3x dx by substituting y equal to 0 in the equation and dy equal to 0. So this will give us 3x squared by 2 from 0 to 1, which is 3 by 2. Now along C2, x plus y equal to 1. So we need to convert it to one of the variables. Say we take y equal to 1 minus x. This implies dy is minus dx. So integral C2 mdx plus ndy is integral 3x minus 8 into 1 minus x whole squared into dx plus integral 4 into 1 minus x minus 6x into 1 minus x into minus dx. Now the starting point of C1 is C2 starts at 1, 0 and ends at 0, 1. This implies x equal to 1 to 0. We cannot change the direction of the curve, and ideally speaking, we always consider the curve in the anti-clockwise direction. So we have integral C2 mdx plus ndy equal to integral 1 to 0 3x minus 8 into 1 minus x whole square plus 4 minus 4x. So when we take this minus sign inside, we get this to be a minus and this as a plus. Plus 6x minus 6x squared dx. So integrating this, we get 3x squared by 2 minus 8 into 1 minus x whole cube by minus 1 into 3 minus 4x plus 4x squared by 2. So we can combine this. So 3 plus 4, 7 plus 6, 13. So 13x squared by 2. Minus 6x cubed by 3 from 1 to 0. When we substitute the limits, the upper limit is always substituted first. So we have minus 13 by 2 plus 8 by 3 into, when x equal to 0, we get 1. When x equal to 1, we get a 0. Minus 4 into 0 minus 1 minus 2 into 0 minus 1. So we get a minus 1. So simplifying this, Now along C3, x equal to 0 and y starts at 1 and ends at 0. So dx equal to 0, this implies we have integral C3 mdx plus ndy equal to integral 1 to 0, 0 plus 4y dy, which is upper limit should be 0, lower limit should be 1, so it will be minus 2. So integral C mdx plus ndy is integral C1 plus integral C2 plus integral C3. So this will be 3 by 2, 13 by 6, minus 2. So 6 being the LCM, we get 10 by 6. Now, the region R is here. So we need to evaluate the right hand side of the Green's theorem. According to Green's theorem, we have integral mdx plus ndy along C is equal to double integral over R dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y dx dy. Now m is 3x minus 8y squared, n is 4y minus 6xy. This implies dou m by dou y is minus 16y, dou n by dou x is minus 6y. Now R is this region, and what we have to do is the evaluation of a double integral. So in this region we have a choice of either a vertical strip or a horizontal strip. If we choose a vertical strip, then limits for R, this will be y equal to 0 to the line x plus y equal to 1, which gives us y equal to 1 minus x. Now x being constant limits, this would be the extreme points of the region. So x will vary from 0, which is the least value, and 1, which is the highest value. So double integral over R dou n by dou x is minus 6y minus dou m by dou y is minus 16y dx dy, which is dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y, which we'll call it as I for convenience. So this will be minus 6y minus of minus 16y. Now we have taken variable limits for y, so y should come first, 0 to 1 minus x, 0 to 1 dy dx, which is integral 0 to 1, integral 0 to 1 minus x, 10y dy dx, which is integral 0 to 1, 10 into y squared by 2, 0 to 1 minus x dx, that is 5 times integral 0 to 1, 1 minus x whole squared dx. which is equal to 5 times one minus x whole cube by 3 into minus 1, 0 to 1. This will be 5 minus 5 by 3 into, when x is 1 we get a 0, when x is 0 we get a 1, which is 5 by 3. Now this is 5 by 3. So we observe that integral m dx plus n dy over c is the same as double integral over r bounded by c dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y dx dy. We consider another example. Verify Green's theorem for x squared minus cos xy dx plus y plus sin x dy. So Green's theorem is, integral c mdx plus n dy is double integral over r dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y dx dy. So we draw the diagram. So we have pi comma 0, pi comma 1, 0 comma 1, and 0 comma 0. So c1, c2, c3, c4. So the anticlockwise direction is to be taken, and when C1, C2, C3, C4 join end to end, it should give us the complete curve C. Now along C1, this is the x-axis. Segment on x-axis, or you can use a two-point formula. So we get y equal to 0. So integral c1 mdx plus n dy will reduce to integral, now y is 0, so we get x squared minus cos h 0 dx dy will be 0, therefore the second term vanishes. Now x is from 0 to pi. Now cos h 0 is equal to 1, so we'll call it as i1. So i1 equal to x cube by 3 minus x from 0 to pi. So this reduces to pi cube by 3 minus pi. Now this is because this is equal to 1. Similarly, along C2 we have the value of x is a constant, which is pi. So x equal to pi, this implies dx equal to 0. So I2 will be integral c2 mdx plus ndy So we get integral y plus sin pi is 0. So we get y dy. Now y equal to 0 to 1. So this will be y squared by 2 from 0 to 1. So we get 1 by 2. Now along C3, y is a constant which is equal to 1. This implies dy equal to 0. Now C3 starts at pi comma 1, ends at 0 comma 1. Therefore, x equal to pi to x equal to 0. So I3 will be integral C3 mdx plus ndy, which is equal to integral pi to 0 x squared minus cos h 1 dx. So this will be x cubed by 3 minus x into cos h 1 from pi to 0, which is 0 minus pi cube by 3 minus cos h 1 into 0 minus pi, which can be simplified. Now for I4, we need to take C4, which is x equal to 0 with y equal to 1 to 0. The starting point is 0 comma 1, ending point is 0 comma 0. So dx will be equal to 0. This implies I4 equal to integral C4 mdx plus ndy, which is integral y dy, and y equal to 1 to 0, which is y squared by 2, 1 to 0. So we have 0 minus 1 by 2, which is minus 1 by 2. Therefore, I4 is minus 1 by 2. So integral C mdx plus ndy will be I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus I4, which will be pi cubed by 3 minus pi plus 1 by 2 plus pi cos h 1 minus pi cubed by 3 minus 1 by 2. So this simplifies to pi into cos h 1 minus 1. Now n by dou x is cos x, and dou n by dou y is minus sin h y. Now R is a rectangle with sides parallel to the coordinate axis, therefore y equal to 0 to 1, x equal to 0 to pi. So double integral over R, dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y dx dy equal to integral 0 to 1 integral 0 to pi cos x minus sin h y. Since the limits for x is written first, so we have dx first, then dy. So this will be integral 0 to 1 sin x plus x into sin h y dy x equal to 0 to pi. This will be integral 0 to 1, 0 minus 0 plus pi minus 0 sin h y dy. So this is integral 0 to 1, pi is a constant, sin h y dy, that is pi into cos h y from 0 to 1, which is pi into cos h 1 minus cos h 0. This is pi into cos h 1 minus 1. So we find from equation 1 and equation 2. So 1 and 2, this implies integral C m dx plus n dy is equal to double integral over R dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y dx dy.